There once was a fellow named Joe, who could have been anyone, though. He's just an example, truly just a sample. Just pretend that he's someone you know. The stories about Joe's info changed, lost, stolen, or wrongfully exchanged. The effects were severe, and in case it's unclear, sensitive was the info engaged. Encrypt those emails, the policy said, but folks preferred to not to instead. So Joe's full name and address were exposed, more or less, to anyone who intercepted the thread. Two doctors discussed records out loud, while waiting for a train in a crowd. Need to know only, they should have thought slowly, before revealing Joe's info aloud. Financial stuff too was at high risk, when tossed in the bin with a motion brisk. Hey look, lots of cash right here in the trash, they should have shredded it first, tisk tisk. The situation was made much worse, when exposed were ratings adverse. I wish that my laptop wasn't left in that shop, it's lost forever along with my purse. I could go into lots more detail of other info sent in the mail, like the pre-award grant or the stuff on the patent that left quite a mess and a long trail. Those folks who should have protected him left Joe in a situation quite grim, but suffice it to say, Joe had had a bad day being another SI breach victim. So please learn from this tale oh so sad, protect all info that you've ever had. PII, PHI, and all other SI. You and those you protect will be glad. Encrypt and conceal and don't discuss. Please shred and redact it if you must. It's all of our duty, oh yes, absolutely, to help us retain the public trust. Report loss and theft within 1 hour, or anything else under your power that may have gotten loose, no matter the excuse, to prevent things from getting more sour. If you have any questions, you know that you can ask your ISSO. Do your part to protect any SI you get, or else anyone could be like Joe.